Hey guys. Nice to see you again. We hope you had a great time since we published our last video. In this video, we will show you different instructions in ST. We already used instructions in some of our previous videos, for example when we talked about enums, structures, pointers and references. In this video we will show you how to use the if instruction, the case instruction, the jump instruction and the return instruction.
Let's start with the if instruction. An if instruction is used to execute an instruction depending on a certain condition. First step is that it tests a certain condition. For example, if the value of a bool variable is true or false. Depending on the result, the instruction will be executed. The syntax looks like this. In the first line you write the condition that should be tested. If start condition then. And in the second line you write the instruction that should be executed if the condition is true. Bananas equals bananas plus 10. You always close with an end if. Additional, you can use the else or else if instruction. The else if instruction tests another new condition. If the conditions before are false, the else instruction will be executed if none of the conditions before are true. Now let's have a look at our banana packing station. If the dinosaur Shminosaur presses the start button, the value behind the button changes from false to true. If the value of the start button is true, 10 bananas will come out of the banana 60 in 3. The bananas are packed in boxes. 20 bananas fit in one box. Because of logistical reasons, the banana 60 in 3 always packs 3 boxes and then resets to 0 to pack the next 60 bananas into 3 boxes. This is an example that we can implement as an if instruction in which specific conditions get tested.
Let's build the situation in TwinCAT. First, we declare the variables we need. Start of type bool. This is the button the dinosaur is pressing. Our bananas of type real. And box 1, box 2, and box 3 of type bool. In the implementation part, we will now write our if instruction. If start then, this is the first condition that needs to be true to start the process. And now we write the instruction. Bananas equals bananas plus 10. Now we nest another if instruction into our first one. With this instruction, we want to set the different boxes to true, depending on the amount of bananas. We also want to reset the counter to 0 if none of the conditions are true. We write. If bananas less than or equal to 20 then. Box 1 equals true. Next, we use the else if instruction. This instruction tests a new condition if the first condition is false. Else if bananas less than or equal to 40. Box 1 equals false. Box 2 equals true. And one else if for the third box. Else if bananas less than or equal to 60. Box 2 equals false. Box 3 equals true. At the end, we use an else. The else is used to execute an instruction if the conditions before are false. We write else box 1, 2, and 3 equals false, bananas equals 0. Behind the if instruction, we write start equals false. To avoid an endless cycle, let's activate the configuration, log in and start the program. We set start to true and the value of bananas changes to 10, and box 1 is set to true. Again, box 1 is true, and the value changed to 20. And again. As you can see, box 1 is set to false now and box 2 is true. Click. 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 It works how it should. If the value of the bananas get higher than 60, the value is set to 0.
Next we will talk about the case instruction. The case instruction is used to group multiple conditional instructions with the same conditional variable in a construct. The case instruction tests the value of a variable of an integer data type. Depending on the value, different instructions can be executed. Let's take a look at the syntax to clarify what that exactly means. It starts with case bananas of. Bananas is a variable of type int. The value of this variable gets tested. In the next line, you can declare an instruction to be executed when the variable has the defined value. The defined value is 12. After the colon, the instruction follows, box 1 equals true. If bananas has the value 12, the variable box 1 of type bool becomes true. If the statement is to be executed for more than one value, you can write the values for which the statement applies, separated by commas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, colon box 2 equals true. Or you can define a certain range of values. 6, dot, dot 11, now the instruction behind the colon is executed for the values from 6 to 11. If none of the values apply, you can optional use an else to define an instruction that is executed in this case. The instruction is closed with an end case. You could also use other instructions inside the case instruction. We already used the case instruction in our video about enums. In this video, you will find an example where we use if instructions inside the case instruction. Let's open TwinCAT. We will use the banana packing station example again, but now we will use the case instruction inside the if instruction. So we delete the if instruction and change the type of bananas from real to int. And now we write case bananas of and define the first value. We write 0 to 20, box 1 equals true. Because the first 20 bananas should be packed in box 1. Next for 21 to 40, box 1 equals false, and box 2 equals true. And for 41 to 60, box 2 equals false. Box 3 equals true. Now we use again the else, if none of the values apply, the instruction behind the else is executed. Bananas equals 0. And box 1, 2, and 3 are false. TwinCAT already inserted an end case, which closes the instruction. Now let's activate the configuration, log in and start the program. Nice. Our case instruction works how it should. Now, let's talk about the jump instruction.
The jump instruction is an unconditional instruction that is used to jump to a certain line in your code. This line has to be marked with a label. Let's take a look at the syntax. The jump instruction is used at the location in the code where the jump should take place. Behind the jump, you write the label. The label is a freely selectable, unique identifier that you put at the beginning of the line to which you want to jump. If the jump instruction is reached, it triggers a jump to the line with the label. You can link the jump to a condition. This can be useful to avoid endless loops. Use, for example, an if instruction. You either use a normal if instruction structure. If a certain conditional variable is true, then jump label 1. End if. Or you shorten it and write jump, behind it, the condition in brackets, and then the label. The condition in brackets must be a Boolean expression. Don't use more than one label in your program. The use of too many labels can cause confusing code.
Sometimes it happens that some rotten bananas fall into one of the boxes. The dinosaur then has to exchange the rotten bananas by hand. Therefore, he skips the part of the station by pressing a button that always adds 10 bananas. In TwinCAT, we use a jump instruction to skip the part of the code that always adds 10 bananas. We declare a stop variable of type bool. This is the stop button. In the first line, we now write our jump instruction. If stopy, then jump stopo. Stopo is the name of our label. End if. Before the case instruction, we insert the stopo label. We log in and start the program. The code runs without the jump. If stopy is set to true, we skip the part of the code that adds 10 bananas. But the case instruction continues to be executed. The dinosaur can take out the rotten bananas. And the station continues to assign the correct box, depending on the amount of bananas. If stopy is set to false again, the code runs again without the JMP instruction. Next,
let's talk about the return instruction.
The return instruction is used to exit a function block. The return instruction can be depending on a condition. Let's take a look at the syntax. If condition 1, then return. End if. In a code, you could use the return instruction like this. Return instruction, depending upon a condition. Code block. If the condition is true, the code that follows won't be executed. Instead, it follows a direct jump to the return at the end of the code. If the condition is false, the return instruction won't be executed, and the code behind it is executed again. Let's try it in TwinCAT. We insert the return instruction at the beginning of our code. We make it dependent upon a condition. If bananas are greater or equal 60, return. End if. We log in and start the program. If the value of banana reaches 60, the return instruction is executed. And the code that follows won't be executed. Now look. After the value of our banana variable reached 60, the condition for the return instruction becomes true. It works.
Now you know how to use the if, case, jump, and return instructions. In our next video, we will talk about the while and the for loop.
Stay tuned and subscribe to our channel for not missing it. And if you want to learn more about TwinCAT 3, watch our other videos.
Have a great day.
See you later, alligator.
Out the door, dinosaur. Hee hee.
Bye.